The other thing is that batting lineup, I really don't see DK batting ahead of Dhoni. I see Dhoni batting at 3 so that he can bat with a clear mind. DK goes at 4 probably. And then the rest of the batting comes around. And then if you have Mahendra Singh Dhoni there, then he'll have the cushion of Dinesh Kartik, Hardik Pandya and Bhuvneshwar Kumar after him. And then you reckon he should be playing with a much, much freer mind.
Robin, you would still prefer to see...
I think the whole world has been talking about this. Literally everyone that you've... As in anyone who's played the game, anyone who's, you know, who understands the game and understands what would be most effective for India wants MS to bat at number 4. I think that... And you know, I think that would really help him and help India, you know, have a lengthier batting order, and there's no pressure really. When he comes in, he can really play a proper role that would serve the team, right? I'm quite baffled as to why he's not batting at number 4, why they don't see the utility of him batting at number 4. But I truly hope he bats at number 4, and it also takes out a lot of pressure from the likes of, say, Rishabh Pant. He's literally in his first 10 ODIs in his career. So you want to take off as much pressure as you can at this big stage, right? So you want him to bat maybe at 5 or 6, you know, so that he can go and express himself freely and play his natural game without having the pressure of, you know, that number 4 on his head. Now, who would be most equipped to deal with that kind of pressure is MS Dhoni. There's no other, nobody else comes to mind. Yes, if the 36 overs are down and you're 2 wickets down for 220, Hardik Pandya is your man for the job at that point in time, right? But when otherwise, I think before 30 overs, MS should bat at number 4. Then you have Rishabh Pant, Dinesh Kartik, Hardik Pandya,
Bhuvneshwar Kumar. Lots of batting.
Absolutely.
Man, that just sounds good, right? Sounds right.
It does sound right. But even if India are not chasing today, there has been the unavoidable, you know, unleashment of the controversy, similar controversy, yeah. You can say, but let's not get controversial. Let's just try and put things in perspective. India not chasing today, but MS Dhoni, we're looking at these numbers in run chases since April 2015. In a 300-plus chase, well, you can see the difference in average in chases over 300 and under 300. Now, today it's not a chase, but yet, essentially, you're chasing a score that you've set yourself.
See, I think the big thing about MS was still, I think, about a couple of years back, in about 50 innings in which he had finished, when India chasing and MS Dhoni was not out, India had won some 48 out of 50 or 48 out of 49 matches. So his record as a finisher, it was unbelievable, absolutely unbelievable. Okay, the fact of the matter is he's not that finisher anymore, and there's nothing wrong with it. Sachin Tendulkar in 1994 and Sachin Tendulkar in, you know,
2013
are very different players. What you have to do is saying that, is he still of value enough to be in this Indian lineup? Yes, he definitely is. Then, if he's of value, where do I fit him in to give me best value? So, my problem is, I don't feel at this point in time, most situations, that Dhoni is a finisher anymore. You have to use him because he needs more balls to set his eyes. Age has caught up. There has to be... You have to give him a little more time. Now, a selector can take the choice whether he says that, do I want to give this player more time or should I get another player? At this point, if the collective wisdom of the Indian team and the captaincy say, no, we still need Dhoni out there, then bat him in a position that gives you most value for him. But if you are going to say that he is the finisher that he was, say, 2013, 2011, 12, 13, 14, those days, I think you're doing him an injustice as well. Because nobody can stop age. So play him where he deserves to play. Play him where he can give you most value. And I don't think they're playing him there.
And this matches with your argument of batting him at number 4, which is no disrespect. You're actually telling him this is what you do best at. And when we've got 6-7 overs to go, you'd much rather have a DK playing his dinky shots and doing that than MS doing what he's not doing at number 4.
So let's take cricket out of the equation. Let's look at this purely as, like, apart from a cricketer's perspective, apart from, let's go with the emotion of MS Dhoni. He I think in the larger perspective in the country, he's an emotion. Now people talk about MS and people think, okay, you know, sixes flying everywhere, batting with absolute freedom, you know, and just going bang, 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 bang all the time, right? Now, I agree with Joyda to the extent that you got to utilize him where he's going to be most useful for your team. I say, send him at number 4 and say, go and express yourself. You know, go there and really just express yourself. You don't have to, you know, take pressure. We don't want you to take the pressure. we'll take the onus. We have guys behind you. We have four guys behind you or three guys behind you who can do the job and who can play that role of a finisher. You go out there and express yourself. You be as demolishing as you can be.